Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. Coming up, we'll use Grok 3 to build a real-time stock trading dashboard, hunt for coffee beans in Barcelona using Cline's new AI app store, and completely take control of a Windows 11 machine using a local AI agent. First up, Grok 3. It's the new AI model that everyone's talking about from Elon Musk's XAI. And apparently, it's really good. So I'm going to test it out here. I'm going to enable thinking so that it can reason over what I give it here. And I'm going to give a very simple prompt. I want it to generate a Python script that pulls real-time market indicators on Tesla from an API called taapi.io. By the way, I've got a video coming up soon where I'm going to create my own automated AI trading agent, so make sure you like and subscribe so you don't miss that video. Okay, it'll present them on a web page with beautiful graphics and update every 10 seconds. The main headline should be buy, hold, or sell those beautiful Tesla stocks. And I want it to use design best practices to make this look incredible, like it was designed by, yes, you got it, an Apple engineer. I'm also going to go underneath it and I'm going to paste in a few documents just to help Grok 3 really nail this. And these will be the TAAPI docs and also some information on how I want it to present API responses. So I'll post that all there. Now, the good thing is it has a pretty long context window. So let's run this with Grok 3 and see what comes back. And you can see it's thinking away here, and it's already thinking about how it's going to make this app. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, it thought for 106 seconds, and now it's giving me all the code I need right in front of my eyes. I'll be able to copy and paste this and use it inside a code editor. I've quickly created a Python virtual environment. Let's install the dependencies here. Now we'll go ahead and create a .env file and insert my real TAAPI key. Note that TAAPI provides real-time data for all kinds of stocks and cryptocurrencies from multiple different exchanges and all in real time. Like I say, video coming up probably next week on building an AI agent that uses these tools. Gonna generate an API key, copy that, and get that pasted over here. And then the final steps that Grok 3 has kindly provided me is just to run the application using this command and visit localhost :8000 in a browser to access it. And boom, like that, we're up and running. We can actually control and click this to open it in a browser. Okay, at the moment, it's just giving me this message, no beautiful website. So I'm going to ask Grok 3, what's up with that? I just get this message, but no beautiful UI webpage. How to get that? And I'm hoping without needing to think, Grok 3 will give me the answer. If I look over this, I can see that it's given me just a few key changes, particularly to the app.py file. So let's implement those changes and open it in a browser. Nothing is showing presently on the web page, and I've got this console error. So I'm going to copy and paste that into Grok and do deep search. So not only can it search for the answer, but it can also reason over the answer. This will take a little bit longer as it thinks away. You can see it's currently thinking, investigating the error, and it's obviously using up-to-date web searches here. So it could well be that something has changed over time with one of the libraries, and it needs to actually reach out to the internet to fix this. Let's see if it works. It already seems to have found an error and it's connecting those CDN URLs. It seems to have done everything that's needed. Okay, with all the code copied and pasted, let's really hope this works now. I'll click to access the web page and boom. Oh, wow. Okay, yeah, it's telling me to hold and yeah, things are appearing here, but it's, wow, it's kind of doing something. It's getting there. But let's see if we can tweak it to look even better. So again, I'm typing to Grok 3. This is working now, but my web page is growing infinitely. Please fix and keep moving line graphs inside the boxes without them growing. And look at this. This is really cool. This is real-time data coming in after a few tweaks. I'm getting a live RSI on the Tesla stocks and also the MACD. Now, I know I asked for more data points, so I'm going to see if Grok can add in more boxes for me. But this already is looking incredible. I've just written here, great, works perfectly. Remember, I wanted many boxes with data and you just gave two. New code written. Let's restart the app and take a look at the web page. And now, wow, look at this. I don't know what any of this means, but it's updating in real time and giving me all kinds of different information from all these different market indicators as to whether I should be buying, holding, or selling Tesla stock. At the moment, it's still stuck on hold, but do you know what I'm going to do? To see if this works, I might leave it running for a bit and update you on whether it changes to buy or sell while I create this video. Stick around and we'll find out if that changes. Remember, this is not financial information or investment advice. Do use your own discretion if you choose to do something like this. Next week on the channel, I will be building a real-time AI trading agent to see if I can take advantage of data points just like this. Remember to like and subscribe if you're enjoying what you see, as I do videos like this weekly. Okay, so as you can see, it's not as simple as a one-shot. And I know a lot of people this week have said, Grok 3 can make things in one shot. Well, that wasn't true in my experience. First, I needed it to think. Then I needed to ask follow-up questions. And finally, when there was a problem that couldn't be solved, I had to use the deep search feature to reach out to the web and reason over what it found to fix things and get my dashboard working. Now, with that said, how does Grok 3 fare up versus, say, ChatGPT? Early benchmarks that are coming in show improved speed. I've definitely noticed it's very speedy. Reasoning is great and understanding is good. Plus, maybe it has a killer feature over ChatGPT, and that is real-time knowledge integration, as it integrates directly with the X platform, giving you real-time data. So let's give this a go for a second attempt. I'm going to start a brand new chat here, and I'm going to ask it, get me stock prices for Tesla and tell me what action I should take right now with $1,000 worth of stocks that I hold. I'm not going to choose deep search or think. I'm just going to see if Grok 3 can access real-time information. It's searching, it's looked at X posts and also some web pages, and very quickly, it's coming back with an answer here, and it tells me as of today, at this is Pacific time, obviously, I'm in GMT, but that's beside the point. It's telling me the stock price of Tesla, which is indeed up to date, although it refers to a few days ago as February 18. So maybe not entirely accurate, but it's getting there. Now, posts on X from like yesterday say that Tesla was down by 1.5%, hinting that, there's something that's unclear here. Given pre-market hours on today, Friday the 21st of February. And it actually gives my suggestion, given the current price and market uncertainty, hold your position, which actually is exactly what the app I just built using Grok 3 told me to do too. So Grok 3 is confirming with its real-time data that what my app has said is accurate. Okay, next up, I want you to meet Cline. It's an extension for Visual Studio Code that helps you to code just like CursorWord or Windsurf or something else like that. But they've introduced something quite unique. It's an MCP marketplace. Well, I want you to think of it as like an app store for AI capabilities, but instead of downloading apps to like your phone, you just simply add superpowers to your AI coding assistant. So how do we do this? Well, first of all, in Visual Studio Code, make sure we go to the extensions tab and that we have Cline installed. If you do, you get this friendly little robot face here. You'll see there's a little extensions icon, and that is for MCP servers. This is essentially their marketplace on all of the different superpowers you can add to your AI. You'll see popular things like Airtable here, Shopify, Spotify, Discord. Any app you can imagine can integrate with your coding agent. And you know what? Last week, I had a play with integrating AI image generation into my coding assistant. This time, I'm going to scroll through the popular ones. And actually, I quite like the idea of integrating Google Maps. It's as easy as a one-click install here. Okay, and I can see here it's asking me for an API key, so I'll simply enter that API key here. It's told me it's got the key. It's setting up the MCP for me automatically, which is really cool. I'll click save. Okay, it tells me it's been successfully sorted, so let's approve this and test the server. And look at that, the response, it's given me the response as the absolute location of Google in California. So it shows that it's working. Now, let's go ahead and try and build something with this MCP inside VS Code using Cline. And here we go. I've written a very simple prompt in Cline. Build me a simple app that will show the top coffee shops in Barcelona on OpenStreetMap. Each pin on the map should look like a coffee bean, and you can hover over to get the info, get the data from Google Maps. Let's execute that. And now you can see Cline wants to use a tool, Google Maps. This is really cool. It's using one of the MCP tools from its marketplace it just launched to get the data to show in my app. Okay, this is really cool. It's found those coffee shops in Barcelona and it's going ahead and adding those coffee shops into my app, which is really, really cool. I'm going to save this and see what it looks like. Let's run the command it suggests. Whoa, look at that. It's created a map of coffee shops in Barcelona. I can hover over these coffee beans and get the names of the shops. It'd be nice if I could see a few more details like reviews and ratings. But you know what? This is exactly what I asked Cline to do, and it's built it for me using the OpenStreetMap as the background. But most importantly, the MCP server that reaches out to the Google Maps API to find the data to lay on my map here. This is awesome. I can move the map around, and it's really cool. I can zoom in and out, which is awesome, but you'll see more more icons appear as I zoom in. But yeah, there's my original coffee bean and I can hover over it. It doesn't work with anything else, but the coffee bean, I can hover over it and find a nice place to get myself a cup of coffee in Barcelona. There you go. I love it. Coffee beans sitting there inside Barcelona, ready for me to use and expand my app in the future. Okay, this is really interesting. Something is changing on the graphs. Let me pull this onto my screen here and show you as the graphs are changing quite dramatically, actually, while I speak. And something is happening with it. It says buy. Remember, this is not financial advice. Okay, last but definitely not least, OmniParser V2 has been released, and this one is totally wild. It's a tool from Microsoft Research, and it turns any AI into a computer use agent. And they've given you this wonderful OmniTool here, which is inside a GitHub repo, which indeed is created by Microsoft. So this is not just some third-party app, this is Microsoft. And what's more, they released inside this OmniTool something which is a Dockerized Windows 11 machine with everything pre-installed to control that Windows 11 machine. So it's given me an overview here. There are three parts to this: the OmniParser server, which runs an API to control your computer, the OmniBox, which is a Windows 11 VM running inside Docker, and Gradio, which essentially is the UI or the web interface to control your computer with. Okay, after a bunch of back and forth on Mac and spending more time than I'd care to let you know, I got about this far, where essentially my Windows VM wouldn't boot and gave me a bunch of errors on the screen. With that said, I went over the install instructions here, and I noticed it said it'll run quickly on Windows and Linux, but no mention of Mac. So maybe you'll get further than me. If you follow these steps step by step and your system supports it, you should get this wonderful AI agent up and running. Suffice to say, OmniParser 2 has amazing features like converting anything on your screen into boxes that can be used and clicked however you choose. Each box has a label that can be accessed by the AI agent, so essentially it allows full computer control. You can use it anywhere, and you can use web agents to browse the web, coding agents to look at your code and write code, OS agents to do things on your Windows system, or hopefully in the future, your Mac system as well. And it's very fast, 0.8 seconds per frame that look like this. You can grab sticky notes, you can get into settings, you can access Word documents, you can write stuff out, you can create all kinds of stuff, look at your system stuff. It's just nuts. VLC, this is looking like the future, but like I say, I wish I could run it. Maybe you will be able to. Here's an example of OmniTool in action. You can buy milk with your web browser by simply saying, "Help me buy some milk." The AI agent will then take full control, access your web browser, go to Instacart, and start going through the motions to buy milk for you. You can also use it to clone a repo. So for instance, it will go to the OmniParser GitHub page, searches on GitHub, finds what it needs, and it's cloned it there to your computer. Check your disk space, for instance. AI agent knows exactly where to click, what to look for, and presents you with its findings. And it can also check settings for updates. So for instance, you can type in, "Help me check if there is any Windows update available." It knows how to go to Windows update, and it can see, and it presents the results to you. Now remember, we're still early. OmniParser V2 is a glimpse into the future where AI and computers merge seamlessly, and humans maybe no longer need to be in the loop. Thanks so much for watching this week. Remember to join my Creator Magic community. It's an awesome place where we share tips, Q&As, help each other, maybe get this thing installed. That'd be cool. Also, we share our amazing no-code projects. The link is down below in the description. I would love to see you there and hear what you're working on. Please like, subscribe, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen that you should watch next. Thanks.